Welcome to another podcast of from Gulf Islands Radio. I'm Rick Dennis, your friendly neighborhood's urban spaceman, and you've landed on Planet Jazz, and this is Ornette Coleman and Charlie Hayden. We'll be right back. Broadway Blues, Arnett Coleman. This week in Planet Jazz, I've got some of your favorite musicians and some favorite jazz quotes from various websites. For example, Charlie Hayden, the well-known bass player, started out playing with Ornette Coleman years ago. And here's a quote from Charlie Hayden. He's talking about his fellow compadres here, I guess. "I want them to come away with discovering the music inside them and not thinking about themselves as jazz musicians, but thinking about themselves as good human beings, striving to be a great person, and maybe, just maybe, they'll become a great musician." As you may know, Charlie Hayden was father-in-law to the actor Jack Black. His daughter, Petra Hayden, married Jack Black. And in fact, Jack has some musical pretensions. And they even recorded a couple of tunes together in the latter years of Charlie Hayden's life. Here once again is Ornette Coleman and Charlie Hayden. We'll be right back. Ira Dennis. David Gordon is your executive producer. And this is Planet Jazz on Gulf Islands Radio. Coming up next, Louis Armstrong. You know, Benny Green once said, anyone can learn what Louis Armstrong knows about music in a few weeks. Anybody can learn what Satchmo knows about music in a few weeks. But wait, there's more to the quote. Nobody can learn to play like Louis Armstrong in 1,000 years. And to give you an example of just what he's talking about, here's a trio of Louis Armstrong tunes. Starting out with Swing You Cats.
Thank you.
The great Louis Armstrong, Satchmo. Of course, he got that distinctive nickname because his original name was Satchelmouth. Now, there's three Louis Armstrong songs without his distinctive gravelly vocals, which, of course, were a showpiece in itself, in themselves, I guess. His vocals were a showpiece in themselves, but there are three instrumental tracks by the one and only Louis Armstrong. So you see what Benny Green means. That's such a great quote, I gotta repeat it. Anyone can learn what Louis Armstrong knows about music in a few weeks. Nobody can learn to play like him in 1,000 years. We heard the Mahogany Hall Stomp, W.C. Handy, St. Louis Blues, and Swing You Cats, Louis Armstrong and the orchestra. And Louis said, If you have to ask what jazz is, you'll never know. Which kind of reminds me of that great line that John Sebastian had in the classic Love and Spoonful pop hit, Do You Believe in Magic? It's like trying to tell a stranger about rock and roll. I mean, where do you start? If you have to ask what jazz is, you'll never know. This is Planet Jazz. I'm Rick Dennis. And as I mentioned before, our executive producer, David Gordon, we're in a different recording studio this week. What a view. A vast expanse of blue water framed by green trees. I guess this is what they mean by rugged, picturesque beauty. Okay, well, we're going to continue now. And as I mentioned before, we've got some jazz quotes to go along with my favorite artist and hopefully yours as well. Here's a great quote from Wes Montgomery. I never practice my guitar. From time to time, I just open the case and throw in a piece of raw meat. Of course, as you know, there were two distinct phases to Wes Montgomery's career. He was a serious jazz guitarist, both by himself and with his brothers on Riverside Records. And then he hit his commercial peak on CTI Records, owned by Creed Taylor. In fact, his instrumental version of Windy was actually a top 40 pop hit back before radio was segregated into different formats. In those days, I think Wes Montgomery's Windy was a hit in the 60s. In those days, any record that people shelled out bucks for was a top 40 hit. It didn't matter whether it was jazz, polka, country and western, or pop. As long as people were buying it, they played it. Here is the great Wes Montgomery. I was always a big Wes Montgomery fan. Whether he was in Riverside or CTI, died long before his time. Wes Montgomery, one of the godfathers of the jazz guitar. This is called Born to Be Blue. Thank you. That's the late, great Wes Montgomery. I don't know about you, but I could tell the difference between the old Riverside Records and the CTI recordings. The CTI recordings were a little smoother. The arrangements were a little less complicated. It was, you know, it was, there was a lot of pop, sounds, flavoring to the CTI recordings. But hey, I love them all. Some people accuse Wes Montgomery of selling out when he hit the pop charts with Windy, but, you know, I have a confession to make, actually. I started out listening to the CTI recordings and then worked my way back to the more hardcore blues of his Riverside days. I thought, when I first heard him on Riverside, I thought, that's Wes Montgomery? Because he approached his art in a different way. However, it's all good. Wes Montgomery, one of the great jazz guitarists. We heard Born to be Blue, and from his CTI days, a track called Up and Atom. Records used to be documents, but now record companies want product. That sounds like something that could have been said by somebody last week who took his music seriously. Actually, it's a quote from the great Stan Getz. Stan Getz had several periods of his career. Of course, he had the early days. Then he really hit the big time with the bossa nova craze in the early 60s. Bossa nova was kind of a mixture of the warm, sultry Brazilian music, the Brazilian samba, and the cool sound of jazz. And nobody got that better than Stan Getz. He teamed up with some of the brilliant Brazilian musicians of the early 60s, like Antonio Carlos Jobim and João Gilberto and his wife Astrid, his wife at the time. And they produced some memorable music in the early 60s. And then Stan Getz went on to other things on his own. So we're going to play three tracks from Stan Getz because, well, why not? How could you play less than three tracks by Stan Getz on a program like this? First of all, we're going to have an early track by Stan Getz called Spring Is Here, which kind of suits a day like today on Salt Spring Island. From somewhere on Salt Spring Island, this is Planet Jazz on Gulf Islands Radio. Thank you. Spring songs are
quiet nights of quiet stars.
quite moody sometimes. Like spring will hang early. Spring really hangs you up the most. I think it's Zoot Sims. I don't think he had the original version, but that was quite moody too.
E ter tempo pra sonhar. Da janela ver seu corcovado, o redentor, que lindo. Quero a vida sempre assim, com você perto de mim, até o apagar da velha chama. E eu que era triste, descrente desse mundo, ao encontrar você eu conheci o que é felicidade, meu amor. Desse mundo, ao encontrar você eu conheci o que é felicidade, meu amor.
I agree with you.
Buddy Hackett's great.
I the great Stan Getz, and three tracks from the early days of his career, Spring Is Here, and then, of course, from the Bossa Nova period and the early 60s, Corcovado, and then Hopscotch from his later years. Artie Shaw was well known for his love of music and his love of beautiful women. A number of famous women called themselves Mrs. Shaw for a brief period of time. I don't think he was the easiest guy to live with. He retired at the height of his fame. But before he retired, he once said memorably, "Jazz was born out of the whiskey bottle, was raised in marijuana, and will expire on cocaine." Well, he was mostly right. Actually, I thought that jazz would expire with heroin, but we still have some great jazz coming out these days. But from the peak of Artie Shaw's career, this is a track called Nightmare, and after that, a track I'm sure that most Artie Shaw fans will recognize.
Thank you.
Artie Shaw and the Summit Ridge Drive. You listen to that track and you get an idea of how rock and roll came to be. There's a real, what he calls the Summit Ridge Drive, there was a real drive to that arrangement. And before that, a song very appropriately entitled Nightmare. It has kind of a nightmarish quality to it. Charlie Trotter once said, a jazz musician can improvise based on his knowledge of music. He understands how things go together. For a chef, once you have that basis, that's when cuisine is truly exciting. Here's a master jazz improviser. Now listen to how Miles Davis takes Thelonious Monk classic like Straight No Chaser and makes it uniquely his own.
We'll be right back.
a master improviser, Miles Davis. Of course, you know, jazz is basically improvisation. That's part of its appeal. But some people, I guess, were better improvisers than others. And the master improviser, in my opinion, was Miles Davis. That was a Thelonious Monk composition, Straight No Chaser, which I imagine you picked up on. That also featured John Coltrane and Cannonball Adderly, who said, "Hypnosis is not a state of mind, it's a fact of life." On this edition of Planet Jazz, we're having what our executive producer, David Gordon, calls Jazzosophy. Easy for him to say, Jazzosophy. We're featuring some quotes from some of the legends of jazz. And then, of course, being the original thinkers we are, we play something by the artist right after that. Count Basie said, and I quote, "Of course, there are a lot of ways you can treat the blues, but it'll still be the blues." This is a man who really knew about the blues because he performed with three of the great blues singers of all time. Well, at least three. Helen Humes, Joe Williams, and Jimmy Rushing. Here is Count Basie and Swingin' the Blues on Planet Jazz.
Thank you. Chicago. Sorry that I can't take you. Going to Chicago. Sorry that I can't take you. There's nothing in Chicago that a monkey woman can do.
That was the great Jimmy Rushing with Count Basie. And the Going to Chicago Blues before that, Swinging the Blues. This is Planet Jazz. I'm Rick Dennis, our executive producer, David Gordon, who's got his work cut out from editing the show. Okay. So next we have Chic Corea, who said, and I quote, this is courtesy of digitalinterviews.com, I feel fortunate to have been with such great musicians. I feel that's really the way I develop my own music and my art form, by getting continually surprised by great musicians and also learning various musicians' approaches and their way. It's the standard way anyone learns a skill, which is apprenticeship. You work with someone who does what you do very well, and you learn the basic ideas, then take it where you want to go. Here's the great Chic Corea.
Thank you.
I go to the last note, Chic Corea, Monk's Mood. And before that, Crystal Silence with Gary Verton, giving out some good vibes there. Okay, one more quote here. This is from the Godfather jazz piano, the great Bill Evans. And he says, jazz is a mental attitude rather than a style. It uses a certain process of the mind expressed spontaneously through some musical instrument, in his case, a piano. He says, I'm concerned with retaining that process. He also says, it bugs me when people refer to jazz as an intellectual theorem. To me, it's all about the feeling, which is, you know, basically my feeling. I don't understand all the mathematical progressions of jazz. It just sounds good to me. Here's Bill Evans on and Bill Evans Trio on Planet Jazz. Thank you. Dave Gordon and I were just talking about how some of the musicians, the kind of music that they provided was very different from the lives they lived. You know, there's a famous line about, there's a thin line between genius and insanity, and people like Bill Evans really straddled that line, I think, but they left behind some great music. That's it for Planet Jazz for this week. as George Gershwin would say, life is a lot like jazz. It's best when you improvise. Bye for now. We'll see you next week on Planet Jazz on Gulf Islands Radio.